We're out here at the Bradford Research Center. Now, William is a junior major in plant sciences at University of Missouri. So he's going to be talking about the solar corridor system. Now, take it on, William.
Well, here we have your traditional, you can see here, your 30-inch grain sorghum rows.
Uh-huh.
With your conventional spacing. And then over to our left here, you can see we have a 60-inch wide row with right now in the middle a Laredo soybeans.
Now, what's a Laredo soybean?
Laredo soybean, well, that's more of a forage type soybean, I believe, compared to your conventional row crop bean.
Okay.
You know, it also helps fixate a little nitrogen.
All right.
Go into the soil to kind of feed our nitrogen needs for our grain sorghum alongside it.
Well, now, so soybeans were normally originally used as a forage, wasn't they?
They were back in the day when it was.
And we found out that they're also high in protein, so we started using them for the seed. So
right.
Instead of 30-inch rows, we got them, like we see here, normally, got them on 60. Now, isn't that kind of, okay, we're going backwards in time?
Say a little bit. Your first thoughts are, well, our yield is automatically going to be cut in half, having, you know, half the rows. But we've kind of increased the population per row of Milo, and as well, and hopefully, in theory, decreasing our fertilizer cost, or more specifically, our nitrogen cost, by having some of this free floating around the air fixation happening down the plant.
And show us what you're talking about with the fixation.
If we come down here and kind of
people
pull
are fixated
up,
with me.
Right. If we kind of pull up lightly, see if we can do it. Some soybeans here, you can see we have some little pods on there, some little nodules.
Nodules, yeah.
Uh-huh. And inside there are bacteria that have a symbiotic relationship with the plant.
Meaning, what's that mean?
Well, the bacteria inside get a little something in exchange that the plant gets a little something. So that they kind of help each other beneficially.
Okay.
So the
versus a parasite.
Parasite.
Yeah, versus a parasite.
Versus a parasite. Exactly. The parasite takes.
Right.
This stuff gives as well. So inside there is where the bacteria lives. And through the plant, and it'll pull the air, and the bacteria will kind of help fixate some of that nitrogen and put it back into the soil and make it more available to the plant to use.
And how do we know if those are working?
Well, if you kind of cut them open really, really nicely, you can just kind of split it.
Well,
and see that dark, pretty pink, kind of salmon color.
Uh-huh.
And that means that we are doing, this plant is doing a really good job of fixing some nitrogen for us.
You've increased the population a little bit. You've got reduced costs. But this wide row probably results in something else, though, too, doesn't it?
It does. In fact, as you can see, instead of having, like over here, we have these three 30-inch Milo rows. This one in the middle is all tall and kind of, and throughout the day, it'll shade
uh-huh.
the other lower leaves of itself and the neighboring plants. So if you come over here and look, you can see our lower leaves have the ability to be radiated by the sun more, capture more sunlight for the whole plant. Increasing the photosynthesis, and in turn, hopefully a little higher grain production.
So we're going to get more photosynthesis on each plant because of these wider rows. And we're also going to have a second crop growing in here. Now we got soybeans, they got something else over here. Now what's this?
Right, over here we have a cowpea, and this is also a really good nitrogen fixer as well. You can kind of see we can pull one up. And you can see all the nodules on this one as well.
It's got more nodules on it.
I would say that it has a lot more nodules on it. And I would go as far to say that it fixes more nitrogen than the Laredo soybean does.
Well, if you look at it, it's much darker green than the soybean. Compare that to over there. So that would almost tell you that it's probably fixing more, isn't it?
I would think so. Plant's a little healthier. Plant's doing a little bit more
mm-hmm.
to the soil. And also, there's potential here for a great grazing. The sorghum as well. It's
wait, just a bit grazing. Wait, we got the sorghum, we got, mm-hmm. got cowpeas, and behind it there's soybeans.
Yep.
So now you're talking about grazing.
Grazing. Well, some people, instead of harvesting the crop mechanically with the combine, will come in the wintertime and feed their cattle, their sheep, their livestock on the grain and have that supplemented by this good forage here of the Laredo soybean or the cowpea. And that kind of provides a well-balanced, might be lacking in an area or two, such as protein, but hopefully with this intercropping of these cowpeas, we don't have any deficiencies in energy or protein, and it's a pretty good system. Or again, this stuff fixes nitrogen, we have a good grain crop, we can come in mechanically harvest it, but we still have all this fodder leaf after we're done harvesting, as well as all this nice green healthy, high protein.
Well, if you let the cowpeas and soybeans go to maturity, we'd also have some seeds, wouldn't we?
We would have some high protein seeds as well. So, and I would think the livestock could eat that. I mean, just the same as like trying to feed soybeans or corn. And
sure.
You'd have some grain there and have a pretty good.
So essentially, you're going to use the cattle to be your harvester.
Right. Instead of having a $500,000 harvester, you can buy a lot of cows with $500,000.
Yeah.
Or sheep.
So I guess you would just turn all out the whole field at once?
With cattle especially, you can't give them the whole field, because if you give them a whole big old field, within a week, they'll be done. They will have taken your whole 3-month winter supply. So if you do use cattle especially, with temporary fence, like poly wire, step-in post, uh-huh. Give them daily nutritions of feed. That way they don't waste it. And with sheep, I've been told you can give the whole field, but they do waste a little, but not near as much as cattle.
So you can use cattle or sheep in this?
You can. Mm. Small and big ruminants alike do wonderful on this.
Really?
Uh-huh.
How about hogs?
Hogs? I'm not sure. I haven't done much with hogs, but I would think a hog could do pretty good. I read in a book earlier from 1947 put out by the Department of Agriculture talking about grain sorghum and how we have these new varieties that we can combine mechanically. And in that book in 1947, they mentioned that people should also look into what they called, quote-unquote, sheeping off grain sorghum. So back in the 40s, we were already having this concept, this idea, and we're just now kind of coming back to it and refining it more into a better technique, more efficient,
sure,
profitable, hopefully, economical way to feed or grow grain.
That's really neat that we could use the cattle to be our harvester. We're using some old technology in a new way. Here's your solar corridor without anything. So if you have a floor crop, like a cowpea or soybean, it can help keep your weeds down.
I would say so, yes.
All right. Well, thanks a lot, William.
Thank you.
And this is a great study.